Welcome back to the channel. So I already did my still worth the video on the iPhone 6s Plus, but in that video, I talked about some highs and also some lows about this phone. And now I just kind of want to hit on the positives of the iPhone 6s Plus and talk about really my top five reasons as to why you should pick up an iPhone 6s Plus in 2020. Now, this is more than five reasons. Honestly, it's probably like eight or seven, but I say top five because it's much more marketable in that way. So one of the main things about the iPhone 6s Plus that I love in 2020 would definitely be the price. The price point of this phone is one of the killer things about this. And for the price that you're paying, I mean, it's one thing to pay like $50 for a phone and feel like you're getting a $50 phone or even a cheaper phone than that. But with the 6S Plus, if you spend $100 to $130 on it, which is probably what you're going to get it for, and I've seen them go for Amazon on that price, and I'll link them down in the description below for that price too, so you can get it from there and help support the channel at the same time. But that price point of these phones, it like you'll pay $100 or $150, whatever it is for this phone, but you'll feel like you have like a $300 or $400 phone from this thing, which is super impressive. Every time I pick up this phone, it just feels like I have like a $300 to $500 phone on my hands, even though this thing only cost me maybe like $100, probably even cheaper than that in most times. So the price point of this phone is definitely one of the best things about this thing, and it even held its value throughout its life. So maybe it released for, so maybe last year was selling for like $160, $170. Now it's selling for like $140, $150. This thing is depreciating at a price point that's really, really nice. It's not going to go down much more probably anytime soon. So if you get it now, you can keep it and not plan on reselling it for a while. So the iPhone 6s Plus in terms of price is really awesome. The second thing would definitely be that check ring jailbreak. That is one of the biggest advancements in modern day modifications that we've seen in a long time for iPhones. And basically it's an unpatchable jailbreak. You can be on any iOS version, you can be on any iPhone 6s, 6s Plus, really, and any model of those phones, any storage variants, it doesn't matter, and you'll be able to jailbreak that specific version of that phone, which is so impressive and so awesome. So you can get an iPhone 6s Plus, any model of it, any iOS version, and you can actually jailbreak it super easily. I even have a tutorial on my channel on how to do that. And whether you want to jailbreak it or not, you have to admit that's a super cool capability that we have on these older iPhones, including the 6s Plus, that we do not have on an iPhone like 11 Pro right now. Even though we do have that uncovered jailbreak that just came out yesterday, it's still a super cool thing that we have that capability on the iPhone 6s Plus for sure. Now, the other thing, the size of this phone is one of the coolest things about it. Not only do you have that Touch ID on the front, which I'll get into in a second, but the size of this phone is really, really nice. And I had my iPhone 6s Plus as a main phone for a long time before I switched to like an iPhone 7 Plus, and that size of these phones is something that I really do like. And for some reason, even though it's the same size as the XS Max, I never really felt like I was going to drop it when I was using it. And I think that has something to do with the bezels. I was able to hold it kind of like on the by the home button and things like that, and I had more of a grip on it versus the XS Max that, you know, I have to kind of hold it by the sides, and if I don't, I'm going to be tapping the screen on it. So the 6s Plus's size is something I really do like, and there is some, I guess, reasoning behind the bezel there, so I guess that's kind of funny. Now the other thing, the iOS 14 update that's going to be coming out, I'm going to throw this in here even though if I don't know 100% for a fact it's getting the update, but if I had to say it, I'm pretty sure the iPhone 6s Plus is also going to be getting that iOS 14 update, which is going to be really, really cool. So whenever this thing gets it, we're going to be able to get another year out of it after that thing releases. So think about it like this: not only do we have the remainder of iOS 13, but if it does truly in fact get iOS 14, we're going to be getting all those iOS 14 versions, and then it's going to be lasting up until like June or August of next year, potentially security updates even longer than that. So that's going to be super impressive, and I cannot wait for this thing to get those specific versions of software. Now the other thing, the performance of this phone, like I said before, the price of this thing is pretty cheap, but the speed and performance of this phone is still really comparable. Last year I found out that in some cases my iPhone 6s Plus was faster than my iPhone 10 and my iPhone 10R, which is so crazy to say. So this phone definitely still has a lot going for it, and in terms of the speed and performance, it's definitely there. It's 100% to get there. It's completely capable for sure. Now another thing, the repairability of this phone, and I'm already over 5, but the repairability of this phone is very, very crucial. If you crack or break anything on this phone, you can easily replace it very, very cheap, very, very easily. If you crack the screen, if you crack the camera, or whatever the case is, it's not going to cost you that much money to fix it, and that really goes into the price point of this phone as well. To maintain a phone like this, it does not cost a lot of money, which is really awesome, and I love hearing that and seeing that. And also, this phone still has a headphone jack. It's so crazy that this phone was the last phone to have a headphone jack, which is cool. It was the last iPhone to have a headphone jack, not the last phone in general, but this was the last iPhone to have a headphone jack, which is so cool. And also, like I stated, it has Touch ID on the front, And some people might not like it, but I do like it. And that's the thing I really hope Apple brings back some way, form, shape, and other form, whatever. I hope they put it in the display. I hope they put it in the power button. Whatever the case is, I hope they bring it in some way. So those are just a couple of reasons as to why I would recommend picking up an iPhone 6S Plus in 2020. If you currently own an iPhone 6S Plus, let me know in the comment section below. I'd love to hear your experience with it and everything. Hit that like button, that would mean so much, but definitely hit that subscribe button. Every single subscriber that we get really does count. So it means so much if you guys could hit that. Also check out the other links down in the description as well. My Twitter, my Instagram, my second channel. All those links are linked down below. I'd really appreciate it if you guys would check it out. More importantly than everything else, I love every single one of you guys. Hopefully I'll catch you guys in the next video. Peace out till then.